Trying to get you to come on this morning to give a testimony prior to the EFT webinar to give the people more hope. See, these things have a tendency to motivate people when they hear from people that's had the type of success that you've had.
Absolutely. Yes. With that regard, this is John Bowen, the truck driver. Yes, sir.
Is there someone else that may have called that you would not want to be John Bowen, the truck driver with?
Not necessarily. I've actually learned how to move in commerce thanks to the Kahan Tazadaq authorized representative.
Now, John, that guy Tazadaq, he's been trying to get you to come on to give a testimony because it really helps others to be encouraged. You don't want to sit back like a fat rat on your own and not share your success. You needed to motivate people like Edward Shelley, who's almost lost all hope.
Yes, sir. Well, with that being said, I have had some serious success with the EFT. As a matter of fact, the EFT, that is one of my go-tos. I love the EFT. It's so straightforward. And it makes sense. Your EFT will go through. But as Kahan Tazadaq has always stated, it's the communication. That's where the magic comes in. But yes, absolutely. I've had success. Matter of fact, let me pull over right here.
Now, the correspondence is what I tell people. The instrument itself is very simple to do. The correspondence is typically... they may, some of them go through, and sometimes you'll find one or two that are trying to challenge you.
Yes, and that is exactly what has happened to me along this journey. Let's see, this is 2023. I think when I signed up, it may have been 2021 when I learned about this information, and I sent a number of EFTs in. I think I want to say I sent about five of them in, and maybe only one of them actually went straight through. And what I mean by that is I did not have to send some additional communications. As a matter of fact, while we're talking, I am looking up to send you some proof, Kahan, of the EFT where I had discharged. I think on the instrument it shows 18, it's either $18,000 or $19,000, where it actually says thank you for sending your communication by mail, we have accepted it, and it shows the dollar amount and the date. Yes, sir. So I'm trying to find that right now.
That you're saying that didn't go straight through, what were their correspondence? What did you do to get those people to comply?
Well, there's a number of correspondence. Now, keep in mind, of course, I really enjoy Kahan Tazadaq's books as well. So the book that actually assisted me was Liberate the Oppressed. That book is like a blueprint Bible. It has all the information that one would need in order to carry out an EFT correctly. So, of course, the correspondence that I sent, it has specific verbiage on it that pretty much defaults them if they do not reply. Now, of course, one would also need to understand offer and acceptance and have a deep understanding as to why that works. I don't have that book right here in front of me. If I did, I would read some of that to you guys. But that is a very powerful book. I do understand initially that it is going to be quite a bit as far as purchasing the book. But I tell you, it is well worth it because you will be able to walk through commerce correctly. And you'll be able to get your EFTs, through and discharge.
Let me ask you this. Did the book pay for itself at least 10 times?
Oh, man. The book itself, it pays for itself immediately. There's no waiting. Once you send in that, your EFT, I mean, words cannot describe that book. I tell you, I walk around with that book everywhere I go. I have it in a backpack, and everywhere I go, I don't let that book get out of my sight. And you guys got to keep in mind, initially I wasn't a book person, but once I was able to see that, hey, reading is where, you get your freedom. You get your freedom from reading. And that book is powerful. Of course, I have a number of other books from Kahan Tazadaq, and there's a number of other books that I'm going to be purchasing from Kahan Tazadaq, because this is remedy. I don't know about all those other people out there that claim this and claim that, but here at this ministry, personally, I have seen success, not just my success, but there's been other people in my class that you are in right now that have had the same similar success that I've had. Now, the discharge of the 18 or 19,000, that was just one of the successes that I've had. I've had success with the Iris Red. I don't want to say their name, but yeah. We Iris is.
Yeah. You're talking about that alphabet group.
Yes.
The alphabet group that, people, they go in and they, every year, debtors are happy to get some sort of check or something from her, but creditors usually get some sort of offer or something to pay.
Yes.
Yeah, that girl, that lady. Yeah, she works for the International Monetary Fund. She's a collection agency. I know her. I've had some encounters with her. She was trying to cite me for $250,000 in back taxes because I had been communicating with some of her stores, and for whatever reason, she felt that I was compelled to pay her $250,000. So I told her, I wanted to get a divorce from her. So I asked that she and I could actually do an audit. So I 1041 her ass. Yeah. I 1041 her. So I only deal with her from a business perspective now.
Absolutely. Absolutely. They tried to get in a contract with me for about $30,000. Now there was another book that I had purchased from Kahan Tazadaq.
This Tazadaq guy, can you find him on the internet anywhere?
Oh, absolutely, you sure can. He has multiple channels that you can get in touch with him at.
I was told that guy was an asshole, man. Some people, tell me this guy's an asshole. He's pretty rude and stern.
Well, I wouldn't necessarily say that. It depends on the individual. But if you can get past that feeling of being afflicted, you're good. You're good. And, I mean, the reason why he's like how he is because he's dealing with a number of different internet personalities. And, there's a certain way to deal with multiple personalities on the internet these days. Mm-hmm. We all know that.
Yeah. Yeah, so you had more than one success story with the EFT, electronic funds transfer.
Absolutely. Multiple success with the EFT. As a matter of fact, I just got to the point because I have all my communications laid out on my desk at the house, and I just got to the point to where I'm about to collect all of them and put them up in a safe because all of them have been set. It's a wonderful feeling. Oh, man. Pray the Most High. Yes, sir. It's a wonderful feeling. Because when you understand the game that is being played against you, you can recognize it for what it is.
Now, let me ask you something, Jordan. initially, before you tried this, you know, when Kahan Tazadaq was suggesting you, hey, man, listen, man, I went from being homeless to, you know, being an entrepreneur working for myself since 09. And you could discharge all of your debts. For years, for over a decade now, he's been telling people, discharge, discharge, discharge your debt. Become a secure party creditor, discharge your debt. Did you think that guy was full of shit? Did you think he was just talking out of the side of his neck?
Absolutely, I did. For me to sit here and say that, that would not be justice. As a matter of fact, I learned about you 6 years ago before I learned about you. And what I mean by that is, I was searching the internet because initially I was interested in 1099 OID, mm-hmm. which is a original issue discount. And I seen one of your videos and I said, man, look at this guy. This guy is going to get arrested. There's no way I'm going to follow what he's saying. He is crazy. So 6 years passed. And one of your new videos popped up. I said, this guy is not being arrested yet. Let me investigate and start looking at his videos and see why he is not being arrested. And so as I began to do so, you know, I was like, man, this guy, he's actually making sense. So one of the videos I had listened to, it was you talking about being able to stand on your square.
Mm-hmm.
And I never really understood that until I started learning with your books and your verbiage. And what you were meaning by that is you have to give consent. You mm-hmm. must give consent to be, you know, beat up or handcuffed. And I never really understood that, because you have to give your power away. And if you do not give your power away and you're not bullied and afraid, they can't do nothing to you
mm-hmm.
from that aspect. But I am thrilled that you have continued to do what you're doing. I try to look at all of your videos all the time, because I'm attracted to the truth. And when one notices the truth from another, you have to go back and continue to get the truth. And something else you're doing that a lot of other people are not doing, you are using the Holy Bible to back up every single thing you are saying. You are using scripture, and it's powerful. Now, if a man or woman is not necessarily...
What's that noise coming from?
It was Shelly, mute out.
It was Shelly, mute yourself, man. He coming back with the same old stuff, man.
Yeah, so if an individual... Well, I don't want to say individual. If a man or a woman is not rooted in the Word, this process could be a little difficult for you to understand at some point, because this truly is a spiritual journey. Please believe that. Please believe that. But I've had multiple, like I said, I've had multiple successes, and I am, as we're talking, I'm scrolling through my email because I'm going to send this, what I was talking about earlier, that says that the debt has been discharged to Kahan Tazadaq, so he can show you on the screen there. Just give me one second here. Let's say starred. Now this was a personal loan. Let's see. I'm going through my email here.
How much was the loan for?
It was $25,000.
So the 19 now, your personal loan for $25,000. Why do you think at this point, John Boyden's debtor didn't come on and let other people know that this worked to give him some sort of encouragement?
I should have done that a long time ago, but what I was doing, Kahan, I was waiting till I had settled all of the communications from the alleged debtors. And I wanted to make sure that I had, that when I spoke, I had a concrete resolution. I don't like to do things half-heartedly. So I wanted to make sure that, hey, I got everything settled. And one of the other reasons why I did it on my own, the Han Tazadaq is a very, very busy man. And I didn't want to call him and pester him with every single thing that I was dealing with as far as communications. Now, I can say when I felt like I really needed to talk to him, I did set up a coaching call. And of course, that communication was private. And I got, you know, assistance with that. I hope that it's okay to use that word. I know there's some words that...
Come on.
Okay. So I wanted to make sure that I got the correct information before I responded to some of these alleged debtors. As a matter of fact, while we're talking, I had success with a recent one. This one, it was about $3,200. It was a previous debt that I had, and excuse me, the alleged debtor did not like the EFT instrument, although they still accepted it because they kept it UCC 3-603B, meaning that, of course, if they keep the instrument, then it has been accepted and there has been discharge. And even if they don't keep it, it's still discharged. Now, I don't know if a lot of people understand that, but please, if you're going to get into this EFT, that is going to be what you hang your hat on, is that UCC code right there that I just stated. Now, I don't have that right here in front of me. That was just kind of off the top of my head. But anyhow, so I sent in the initial EFT, and but believe it or not, I actually got a phone call from them. Somebody else that was trying to contract with me, we'll just say that. And she wanted to reach out to me to see exactly what I meant by sending the EFT instrument into her. And I told her, I said, well, it's a self-executing instrument, meaning that if you do not comply, then you agree. And of course, we kind of went back and forth through the mail, and I finally said, if you don't agree with everything that is stated within the communication, then send it all back. She said, okay, all right, well, we'll send it all back. I said, all right. So I waited a few days. I got the information. My wife told me, she said, hey, you got a thick package that has come back. I said, really? I said, okay. So I got home, opened it up. All the communications that I had with the company were in that package. But guess what was not in the package?
EFT instrument.
The EFT instrument. The only thing that mattered. So what that told me is I sent in a valid instrument. They accepted the instrument and the debt was discharged. Now, there's a lot I just said there, because there's a lot of laws that backed up what I just said. And once again, we have to understand offer and acceptance. So anyhow, moving on, the same debt, they decided that they were going to give that debt to a collection agency. So I said, okay, all right, well, we're going to play this game. So initially, once again, referring back to Liberate the Oppressed, there's a document in there that is used for debt validation. And when I say it's powerful, oh man, it is powerful. It'll leave your debtor with two black eyes after it's done. It's so powerful. But so I sent that document into them, and then they decided to respond it was so powerful that they didn't even want to address it. So I said, okay. So after that, I went ahead and set up a coaching call with Kahan Tazadaq, because you know what, you're always learning at this, and I'm still learning, and I'll continue to still learn. So anyhow, I set up my communication or my meeting with Kahan Tazadaq's authorized representative, and he said, is it okay for me to tell him what your authorized representative stated?
Yeah, sure, sure.
Okay. All right. So he said, what you need to do, you need to send in your communications that you've had to show that that was a binding contract between you and the CFO. I said, okay. And then there was another document he said that I needed to send as well. And that, I don't have that in front of me, but that document had stated something along the lines like, if you continue to pursue this EFT that has been
that's the typical unconditional acceptance that he uses. That's in most of his books. To continue to attempt to collect on a debt that has actually already been set off, set on close, may leads me to believe that you may be guilty of fraud and shall incur a penalty of X amount of dollars.
Yes, yes. Yeah. And the amount that I put in was $100,000. And folks, that now has been a month, and I haven't heard from them since, because I sent a valid instrument. And I'm sure they went back to look at my paperwork as a secured party creditor, where I had, you know, set up everything beforehand, and they looked at it, and this was a law firm. This was not just, you know, some sort of junk debt collector. So you know, they were coming, but they just disappeared. So once again, that's another debt that has been satisfied by the Kahan Tazadaq. It is a wonderful feeling.
Let me ask you this, John. Out of all of them, the accepted for value, the 1099 OID, and the EFT, would you say by far the EFT is the simplest? Most people believe that the EFT is the simplest and easiest to get resolved.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Now, excuse me, I'm familiar with the 1099 OID and the A for V. Once again, going back to Liberate the Oppressed has all three of those remedies in that book. Now, the A for V, it requires a bit more as far as like your understanding, but through small bits and pieces of reading, and then backing off, and then going back and reading again, I'm starting to understand how the A for V works and why it works. But I have not been able to send anything in for the A for V yet. I'm looking to do my mortgage, you know, here at some point.
Now, let me say this. You can't EFT a mortgage. Let me just make that clear. You cannot EFT a mortgage. You cannot do an EFT on mortgages or at credit unions.
Gone. Okay.
Now, everyone on the call, remember I said that. Do not try to EFT a mortgage. If you want to get rid of a mortgage, you need to get that new book, John, Why Am I Here? How to Purchase a Mortgage Without Money and How to Really Set Off One. If you're going to set it off, you want to get the War on Aphasia. That's dealing with someone that may, if they stop paying the mortgage, you're going to go into foreclosure. That has both methods in there for non-judicial states and judicial states.
Okay. Okay. Is that book number two or book number one?
Well, book number two has everything book number one has in it. Number two, I only made 47 copies out. Because, you know, just like, I guess that was the spirit, just like the movie 47 Ronin. I just came up with a number 47, man, off of my head, man. And one of them's mine. Kadar wants one. A couple people already bought one, so there's only 40-some left.
Con. Is Kadar on here?
Yeah, he's on here.
Oh.
Right here,
how you doing?
Barack Shaw wanted one, man. You know, he told me to hold one for him, man. I guess I'll give it to him in Shemaya. Verbal. Viva Vose. If I make it there, if that's where he went, I don't know.
Rest in peace, Barack Shaw. Rest in peace, Marty Marr. And as far as Marty Marr, there were some of his videos that I was looking at alongside with you, and I tell you, he was his voice was one of the other reasons that made me get into this as well. You know, he had said something like, you know, over here, you know, folks are getting real remedy. Folks are really setting things off. You need to come here. You need to give us a try. And he just kept pushing. And I said, man, I really like him. I'm sorry that, you know, things turned out the way that they did, but he was a good man.
Mm-hmm.
He was a good man.
Yep.
Him and Barack Shaw. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes.
But all right, Drew, we appreciate that. We're going to commence doing, man. I just wanted you to tell, you know, so these people could hear it live from someone that's actually been doing this stuff. You know, Ephraim Smith, he did it. He discharged $30,000 student loan, $35,000 on the auto loan. He was working on something else. Now, he done went off, quit his job, and started his own business.
Yeah. As a matter of fact, Ephraim Smith, he was in one of my classes. That is one of the individuals I was talking about that you'll take these classes with, and then you'll see them perform. They'll give a testimony, and you'll be able to link the two together. Like, man, I was in class with that man or that woman. That person is telling the truth. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. What I was looking for, Kahan, is on my other phone. When I get back home today, in about 30 minutes, I'm going to forward that to you, because I know there's probably some people on the call that are saying, man, he said he was going to show us this and he hadn't showed us yet. I'm a man of my word, because by me sending and showing that to you, to show them, that's going to be encouragement, and that's going to get somebody to do whatever it is that they need to do. Huh. Man, I thought I had it on this phone, but I did not have it on this phone.
Come, brother, come.
Tom.
All right, so we appreciate the testimony, Juwan. We're going to get back to this, man. Who knows? I might call up Nefertali and let him, you know, a little later, let him share his input if he fills up to it. Because he used a lot of the EFT to get out of all the debt that he was in. Now, he didn't want to board a house. This man went from coming straight out of prison, learning this. Now, he went and board a house.
Kahan, hold on, Kahan. I have it right here.
Mm-hmm.
I have it. Okay. Let me save it. Let me go to your text message right here, and I'm gonna send it to you.
Can you send it to the email tazadaqshah@yahoo.com so I can share it on the screen?
Okay. All right.
We're gonna block your name out. Whatever.
Okay.
Specific information in it.
Okay. Let's see here. All right. What was that email again, Kahan?
Tazadaqshah. TazadaqShah@yahoo.com.
Okay,
Con, let's brother, see. Con.
Insert photo. All right.
Showing the man at the beat jumping.
So, the only information in here is going to be my first name, and it says $18,679.22. Boom. I just sent it. So that way you can
we'll see it, yeah.
Okay, it just now sent. It should say sent from iPhone.
Mm.
Now, while you're waiting on that, one more testimony, right quick. I'll make this one quick.
Mm-hmm.
Now the one that went straight through, that one was over $5,000. I want to say that one might have been $5,300. I sent the initial EFT communication to the company. They received it, and then boom, that was it. I went and looked at my credit. It said paid in full, account closed, done. That was it.
So 25, 17, you talking about 47,000 in debt that you done settle up there?
Yeah, I got so many papers at the house that, you know, I keep on the desk just in case somebody is trying to, you know, do a communication. I've gotten rid of a lot of stuff. That's why you really hadn't heard from me too much, because I've been in the back putting out these fires, Cajun. It's wonderful. I get up. I'm not scared of my mailbox no more. Cajun.
I invite you to come out to my upcoming EFT debt discharge.
Yes, sir.
So there's roughly over 47,000, just the ones that you've shared.
Yes. Yes. And that's the ones that I can remember off the top of my head. This process works, y'all. It's powerful. I love it. Love the EFT.
Yes. Yeah. It definitely helped me out when I needed it. I don't need it anymore. I don't get in debt. I still don't see that email up. You sent it to the right one?
Yeah.
tazadaqshah@yahoo.com
Tazadaqshah.
I don't even see it in the spam.
Sent. Yeah, tazadaqshah@yahoo.com says that it's sent at 12:01. Sent from my iPhone.
Yeah, nothing.
You think you're spam?
Just checked it. Nothing in spam.
No. Let me send it again. Let me forward, include the attachment. tazadaqshah@yahoo.com
While he's on, any of you participants have any questions for Juan?
Sure, I'll take questions.
Any of you have any questions?
If you have a credit card and you discharge that debt, can you use the credit card again, or that's it?
No, close it. It's for settlement and closure. So let me say this. The EFT should always be for settlement and closure. You don't want to keep it open. They'll put the debt back on it.
Correct.
I could attest to that because I was doing it again for another credit card debt. It was for, I believe like 5 G's.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently the EFT instrument that I sent wasn't the exact amount of what was there, even though I'm pretty sure it was, but what I think happened was the interest added on top while they were processing that instrument. So when they deducted the amount of the EFT, it was still left over, literally like $4 of interest. So I paid it off like I would normally pay it, and they put it back. They put back the 5Gs. So I just had to send it, you know, again to accommodate the interest. So if you try to use the card again, even paying it off normally, they're gonna put that debt back on.
Yeah, EFT is only for settlement and closure. Israel did that. He kept the card open. They wiped the balance out. A couple months later, boom, pops back up. You close the account.
Thank you for explaining that.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh, can I speak?
Yes. Ask Alicia. Alicia, can you speak? Go ahead.
Okay. I'm so glad that you brought
is
that
this
up.
Alicia, man, I can't, what name she got this time? Leah? Is this the Alicia of T-Dog? Huh?
Hi, it is.
Damn. Nice voice. Damn. She got a lot of last names. Go ahead.
Okay, all right. Whoever the last gentleman was, I'm so glad that you brought that up, because that popped up something else in my head. Two of my EFTs, I purposely sent an excess amount. So quick example, if the debt was $100, I sent $110. And those companies, they sent me checks back. I have copies of those checks that I received from those banks to make sure that, I had another form of proof to show that, hey.
So like, John, you password protected this document. I can't open it.
Oh, man, why did it do that?
It says, please enter the password below. I have no clue what the password is, man.
Why in the world? Well, I just composed it from my iPhone.
Hold on. No, that's from someone else. Hold on.
Okay.
Let's see. Oh, here it is right there. Thank you so much for your payment.
Come on.
Let's see. Hold on. This is mixing with the Borderlines email. Borderline still keeps sending me emails, Kadar. All this damn time, man. Please help me discharge this debt. Damn, man.
They should call.
Nah, man. It's something different, Joy. My Borderline. Every now and again, she resurfaced, man. Discharge a debt. I haven't seen you in 7 years. What the hell are you talking about?
Been on here.
Huh?
Should have just came on here.
Do nothing like that. She's a borderline. Huh? This is someone I used to deal with in a relationship. That's what she wants me to do. It. Yeah, straight borderline. Huh? Someone was telling you was cutting herself. Now right here. Here's his email. Slide this over, man, if I can. Thank you for your payment. Hi, John. Thanks so much for the payment you sent by mail. We posted it to your account. Check it out.
Yeah, amount, I'm checking it.
$18,679.22. October the 5th, 2021. Check number. It's really an instrument number. And you can see this is not from himself.
Huh.
Yeah. This is from, that's a borderline's email. That's why your email wasn't coming through. For some reason, it was getting intermingled with hers. Look at that. Look, Shalom, can you please help me discharge this debt? Look at that, man. As you see, I don't respond. Still just going, just been going in. So his email got intertwined between, and she password protected it. Shalom, I really need help. I had to replace my white axle. What the hell does that got to do with me, man? Straight borderline, man. Look at that, man. And she password protected this, man. So she's not a complete idiot, man. Look at that. I thought that was John. That's her. Wow.
Going back to that email that John sent, would that be considered a statement of account to be used as proof?
Yeah. I mean, I'm sure he... Yeah, email is considered to be a court record. Huh? You know what I mean? They email us. We don't show up. You get a failure to appear. Electronic mail is just like the regular mail now. That's your receipt. You know how when you track a certified mail receipt, if you don't do the paper copy, you just go online, print it out, and that's your proof that it was sent, that someone signed for it. So the proof of this email coming from someone's, you know, business, that's the proof. It's electronic mail.
Card.
Proof. That's how they're getting a lot of people in court, man. That's how they done, who just told me, man, I messed up when I gave him my email. I think that was one of the brothers on the call. Then they just sent them an email.
That's the phone.
Yeah. And tell them you don't, I don't do computers. I don't have an email. That's the way I'm dealing with people now. Huh? Get them easy. They let you down easy. All right, John, we appreciate it, man. We're going to commence to the webinar now. Good brother.
Peace.
Hey, have a good day, man. Be safe.